the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Whoa! Show me Family Feud. All right, they take control. Only 15 people in the survey said that. Yeah. And speaking of watching sports programs, Rob, how you doing, my man? One more time, let's do that. Nice to meet you. Put her there, Rob.
Oh, no.
Okay. All right, just a little test, Rob, to see if those were for real. Those are some big arms you got there. Put one up against beside my head, let's see what's bigger, your arm or my head. Let's do it this way. All right, now put your head down here, Rob.
Look at that, pal.
Just in case you get any ideas.
Name a star whose parent was also a star.
I'm gonna become Harold's worst nightmare, a game show host.
Survey says?
I'm just a gigolo, I host a game show. Everybody knows.
Besides food, name something you might find in a picnic basket.
Utensils.
Show me utensils. We need underdog. That wouldn't happen if we had a Vanna White on this show. I cannot bring myself to say, show me urine. I can't do it. I can't do it. Let me see. I'm going to try how about. That's what I'm going to do. How about? Bob Barker doesn't have these problems. How about urine? And tookie, tookie, tookie. Well, I'm prepared. I'm well ready for this. We have four children and number five on the way.
Wow.
That's right. Yeah, thank you. I'm not Catholic. I'm just careless. And
number three.
The Fisher family has one.
Teresa, thank you for coughing on your hand just before the show.
You got the top three answers on the board. Is your hair looking good enough, Chase?
Oh, let me just, you got a mirror?
I was ready to read the question. You could have been stuck right there. Right, just like that.
Okay. Here's your forehead.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Just kidding. I'm sorry.
I hope when you go on your mission that you live right next to some Jehovah Witnesses, Chase. All right.
I hope so, too.
That's right, pal. Mess with me. Jinx you, pal. Somebody steal your bike. Jason's getting ready to go be a missionary for the Mormon church. And we all know what that means. It's a very straight religion. And I just have to say, yesterday we made some comments about the Jehovah Witnesses. And it was a joke, and we didn't really mean it. And we respect all religions. And
the Richardson family zero. We'll be right back with Family Feud. Don't go away.
Let's see if you read the Bible or if you can remember something you read. Name a famous biblical twosome. Twosome means two, Chris, just in case.
Laurel and Hardy.
Laurel and Hardy, okay.
They're biblical, though.
Your son.
I try.
That was in the, what was it, Book of Goofy? What was the book of that in the Bible? I mean, Laurel and Hardy. We'll see if it's there, Chris. I think this could be strike two.
No.
Laurel and Hardy!
You seem so energetic, and somebody told me that you are a wrestler.
That's right.
You wrestle with the gorgeous ladies of wrestling. Is that right?
Yes, I'm the Royal Hawaiian.
You are the Royal Hawaiian.
I am the
Royal. And I thought that was a ship. It's a name. Now, you have a big diner, and I'm going to have to get back to the question. But now, I used to wrestle, and I always wanted to beat them. You think you can pick me up?
Of course.
Real fast. Let's see if you can do it. Hurry up, real fast.
All right.
Now we're going around like this.
My fiance's going to be watching, but I'll give you a bear hug.
Yeah! Thank you.
called the Michael J. Fox. And I don't think you should really judge a person until you walk in their shoes. And so what I'd like to do, Kim, is trade you shoes right now. If you wouldn't mind just stepping out here. Trade me shoes. I just want to show that I could appear to be a lot higher if I could wear high heels like women do. Let me have your shoes. Put mine on, Kim. Put my shoes on, Kim. There you go, back with the family. Back with your family, Kim. I can dig it. All right. I think I'm ready to get a job at night. Okay, Kim. Well, we've got a real feud. We're going all the way to $300 and come back. We'll be right here. Herb. Name a place where you just know you'll have to stand in line.
Where you have to stand in line.
3 seconds.
The beach.
The beach.
Okay. Good answer! Yeah.
Are you through with that wave? I'm next.
But it's that little pipsqueak Doug Llewellyn I'd like to choke to death, you know? I'd like to get my hands on his blow dryer, you know, and just kind of crimp it up so he couldn't get his hair's up there higher than a game show host, you know? He really gets it up there.
Name something you might buy that could turn out to be...
Excuse me?
It's my wife again. Hold on, I'll be right back. She always seems to call me. Hold on a second. Honey, don't call me here, okay? We're trying to do a show. What, the diamond ring was phony? I swear they told me it was real. I'll talk to you later. Keeps calling me here. She did it yesterday. Back again. But when you were up there, before you even slapped the buzzer, you started laughing.
I know it.
I don't want you to tell me what you were thinking.
It was a naughty, nasty.
You don't want to tell me what your other answer was.
No, what all I can say was I still have my vision. I wouldn't have gone blind.
It has to do with magazines, he says. Don.
Yeah, his magazine. The other show prompted that.
Rick, I think we can
picture I take that here. Back.
Get a shot of my cue card guy. This is him over here. Scott, step out here real fast. Let me just... People, take a look at him. Yeah. Ronald McDonald Reject. A lovely Janilyn.
Yes.
Now that's a lovely name. You know, we kiss on this show.
Oh, we do. Good.
Well, normally
you
we don't, but
better than Richard Dawson.
Well, I haven't kissed him lately, but it was a cheap shot for me to get a kiss from a pretty girl, and I'm glad I did it.
I'm glad you did, too.
Nick, you're glad I did, too?
Yes.
I'm married.
So am I.
So are you.
Almost.
We'll talk after the show, huh?
And Sabrina is also Kimberly's
Martin,
cousin.
You were telling me what...
We're brothers.
You know,
David
and
Martin are brothers.
I was a little shorter.
You were a little shorter. I'd like to see the doctor's face when you were twins. Is that what you
twins.
Said?
Twins. Identical.
You people are laughing, but this is possible. It's possible. It goes back, it's genetics for thousands. In fact, there's a little nepotism on the show. My brother works on the show. People usually don't get to see him. Stu? Stu? Would you say hi? Yeah. Thanks, Stu.
Men name something women borrow from each other. Chris.
One another's husbands.
Their husbands. Chris.
You never know, right?
You never know?
Never know.
But it seems a bit strange. I can imagine that conversation. Hello, Mom? Yeah. Do what? Hey, hold this, Jason. It's for you. It's your mom. Oh. Jason, or if not, they're going for the steal. Show me the little shops. Do what? Okay, yeah, we do have a misspelling there, but... That's okay. It's my brother. Okay. He had to get a job somewhere. Happened to me. But the question that you didn't talk about was I asked, name the color of M&M's that you would eat first. And you said you wouldn't eat green ones. You said you wouldn't eat green, and I asked you why. And you said the reason was, why don't you eat green M&M's?
Not me personally. I just know you pull a lot of people. And
if you pull a lot of people, what?
If you pull a lot of people, it's been said that the green ones... make you the big H.
What's the big H?
What's the big H?
Corny.
If you have found some kind of a scientific breakthrough, you should share it with the world. And if it's green M&Ms, you can make a lot of people happy in their relationship.
We'll see.
You know, if I, all the times I was a kid younger, I would have been slipping green M&Ms in my girlfriend's M&Ms. You know, she'd have been saying, these are all green. Well, just eat them, honey. You'll feel better.
Revealed to us a startling medical fact in the last show. One of the questions was, name an M&M you would eat last, and she said the green ones. When I pressed her on it, she said if you ask most anyone, they will tell you the green M&Ms make you horny. That's true, though. Isn't that true?
I did say that. It's a story I've heard.
I know you've heard it. And you know what? I think there's only one way, in the interest of science. I personally... I have gone out... Wait a minute. I figure... Let me get a shot of that.
Can you fly my husband here really quick?
I'll tell you what I want to try to do. Just take a handful, if you would, and eat some. Go real fast. You eat some, I'll eat some. We'll see what happens if I go around, see if I look more human. That guy, you said about it. No! We don't want him in on this. You and me. I lost my card. I got all excited, forgot where I was. Did anybody see it?
I saw something.
You saw it? Hey, where's the card with the question? I got all shook up. They're already working.
All right.
Let's go.
Little kiss for luck. All right.
That's great.
I ask you something cars have two of. The engineer from the United States Marine Corps said, tires. Now, I never went to engineering school, but can you tell me... That would seem more like a bicycle, wouldn't it, to you, Lloyd?
Yeah, a motorcycle, maybe.
Maybe a motorcycle.
Yeah.
Motorcycle car slash car. Yeah. But it's probably a secret military weapon that only you know about.
Yeah.
It's the car, two-tire weapon. The enemy see it coming, they start laughing, they can't fight. Our survey said... Apparently no military people in that survey, Lloyd. I ask you, even your family's laughing. They know you're not getting the cash. We all know you're not getting the cash.
We're doing good.
We're doing good, though. Something you do in a driving test, you said pass. Our survey said, two people said pass.